Hey, space friends, this week I am geeking out about weird exoplanets. Weird exoplanets are really fun to think about. Exoplanets, just as a reminder to you, just means extrasolar planets, which means planets around other stars. So pretty much every planet that exists that's not in our solar system, that's considered an exoplanet. There are a lot of exoplanets out there in the universe, and it's really exciting to think about them, and especially think about the weird ones. To date, we've only been able to image around a dozen or so exoplanets. There's still a lot left to be discovered. Actually, getting direct images of exoplanets is incredibly hard currently, but I've done a video about the ones that we have been able to directly detect. Spoiler alert, they're just tiny little pixels, at least for now. But it's fun to think about all these different characteristics that we're learning about exoplanets so far. And that's what I really wanted to explore today, all the weird exoplanets that we are learning about. A caveat is that we still don't know a lot about these exoplanets. There are some that we just don't know much about their characteristics or their mass or much about them really at all. But we can begin to theorize what these exoplanets might be like based on the evidence that we've discovered thus far. And that's what I wanted to share with all of you today. All of those weird exoplanets where we've discovered some characteristics that hint at the weirdness of what it would be like to actually be there. For example, the exoplanet Kepler-22b is thought to be a water world, just a world full of water. But we don't know much about its surface composition or its mass. And this points to kind of where we are with exoplanets. We get really intriguing little details about them, but we might not know the full story. An interesting exoplanet to think about is the planet HD189733b. It is a delight to actually try and memorize all of the names of these exoplanets. Hopefully they'll have more interesting names in the future. But this exoplanet is interesting because it's a hot Jupiter, and we are discovering many hot Jupiters out in the universe. Hot Jupiter is just like it sounds, a Jupiter-like planet that is orbiting much closer to its star and thus is much hotter. What makes HD189733b really interesting is the fact that it is thought to actually rain glass. Not only does it rain glass, which is kind of terrifying to think about, but it rains glass sideways at 7,000 kilometers per hour. It's not thought that there's any water on this exoplanet, but the idea of thinking about glass that rains sideways at 7,000 kilometers per hour is, well, I don't know. It's definitely something to imagine and not really hope to ever visit. Another really hot exoplanet, but in a totally different way, is 55 Cancri E. And this exoplanet is really interesting. It orbits 25 times closer to its star than Mercury does to our sun. It's also tidally locked, so it only shows one side of itself to its star at any given time. So it's really hot, really close to its star. But what's interesting about it is that it's thought to be covered in a blanket of steam. Because it's so close to this star, it's covered in this blanket of steam just throughout the entire planet. Also interesting because it's also thought to have a mantle of diamond. Because there's carbon and because it's being pressurized so much, it's thought that its mantle is diamond and maybe its surface is a combination of graphite and diamond. A really interesting hot planet that is covered in steam and full of diamond. To me, it's really fun to just generally dream about tidally locked planets. Tidally locked planets are just fascinating because they have that one side that always faces the star that's scorched and another side that faces away that's likely freezing cold. Researchers have long thought about there being a narrow band between the hot side and the cold side of these planets where life could maybe survive. It's really interesting to think about, and it's not only interesting to think about scientifically, but you can also read about it in fiction. My friend Charlie Jane Anders made a book called City in the Middle of the Night that is all about actually exploring what it would be like to live on one of these tidally locked planets in that narrow band of habitability. Another interesting tidally locked exoplanet is HAT-P7b, and this exoplanet is interesting because people think that it rains rubies and sapphires on this exoplanet. So it rains rubies and sapphires on this exoplanet. It's tidally locked. It's thought to have clouds on the backside, cold side of the planet. And it's just really interesting. This exoplanet is actually the very first gas giant where we've been able to witness weather on it. Yet another tidally locked exoplanet is WASP 76b. And this exoplanet is really interesting, and it was recently discovered that it's thought that it actually rains iron. How this happens is because this exoplanet is heated up so much, above 2400 degrees Celsius, that it's hot enough to actually vaporize metal. So what happens on the tidally locked side that's facing the star is that it gets so incredibly hot that it vaporizes metal into the atmosphere, and that vaporized metal then rains down on the cold side in the form of iron. So this exoplanet is actually raining iron on its cold side, which is, I don't know, I've run out of words to describe all of these exoplanets other than that they are just weird and fabulous. I also really like the exoplanet KELT 11b. This exoplanet is interesting because it's 40% larger than Jupiter, but only 1/5 of its mass. So it's actually got the density of around styrofoam. So it's essentially a styrofoam planet, which is fun to think about. But the thing about KELT 11b that really tugs at my heartstrings is the fact that it's probably only going to be around for another 100 million years or so. This is because its star will go into red giant mode and will subsume the styrofoam planet. So we should appreciate it while it lasts. Speaking of lightweight worlds, another couple of exoplanets that I really like that are like that are Kepler 51b and 51d. These two exoplanets are considered newborn exoplanets. They haven't existed for that long. Their star is only around 500 million years old, compared to our star, which is around 4.6 billion years old. But the thing that makes Kepler 51b and 51d really fascinating is the fact that their density is closer to cotton candy. Specifically packaged cotton candy that you would get at a grocery store. Why do we know this? Well, the researcher who studied them actually tested this out. At first, the researcher wanted to see maybe if they were the density of marshmallows, but it turns out that marshmallows are even denser than these two exoplanets are. So then, looking at cotton candy, she found that cotton candy is actually too lightweight when it's freshly spun. But the cotton candy that you find prepackaged in some sort of store or shop or wherever you can find it is around the same density as these exoplanets. These exoplanets are known as super puffs for, well, obvious reasons. Okay, so I could keep geeking out about all the weird exoplanets, but those are just a few that I wanted to share with you so far. What's really fascinating to think about to me, and what's really exciting to think about, is the fact that we might be the weird ones. I'm talking about all these weird exoplanets that we've discovered so far, but they might be weird only because we are weird. We haven't discovered a lot of solar systems like ours. We haven't really discovered any solar systems just like ours just yet. Some of this is probably due to the tech that we're using. It's not easy to find tiny planets like ours in the cosmos just yet with the tech that we have. But we are discovering a lot of planets out there in the cosmos that don't look anything like the planets that we have in our own solar system. Things like hot Jupiters, those Jupiters that orbit very close to their stars, we don't have one in our solar system, but they appear to be common so far. So while it's fun to think about space exploration and all these weird planets that might exist out there, others might be looking to us and thinking that we are the weird ones, which, I don't know, is always fun to me. Okay, that's it for me this week. Look at the YouTube description below because I will put relevant links to this episode if you want to read more about any of this topic. Also, a huge shout out to the really awesome patrons that are helping support videos like this one. They are listed in the YouTube description below. If you also want to become a patron and help support videos like this, head on over to my Patreon campaign and you can get cool stuff as well. I will see all of you next week, and remember to always be exploring.